Hi guys, I make this video today to offer my conscious choice to retract statements about this one Mark Anthony Lefebvre, and to apologise not only to my audience but to Mark himself. So to fill you dudes in, I'd accused Mark of being the same man by the same name of Mark Anthony Lefebvre, a convicted criminal who it turns out had committed a bunch of crimes, which is obviously bad. But after some further investigation and some rudimentary Googling, it turns out that this convicted criminal is still actually in prison. Crazy, huh? So I had to buy some disguises for this investigation. You know, we all wear some sort of mask in one way or another, don't we? So I was about to leave for Florida and do a thorough investigative research trip, a field report, you could say. And I had some other locations on my list as well. But before I departed, I decided to get some info from Clay County on the guy I thought was Mark. It turns out he was still actually incarcerated. And I thought over that new knowledge and thought, maybe I should probably delete the accusation video. And then after that, I reached out to Mark to say sorry. So, yeah, you guys might be wondering how I came to this idea. It was simply a weird number of coincidences that occurred a little too convenient. The crime in question was committed in 2014. Thought funny that it's 2014 is also the year that Mark talks about his world falling apart. I don't know where it actually fell, but I just hope he picked it up and dusted it off. So this man Mark, he runs two things and two things alone, the Peterson Sphere, and the other is a YouTube channel called Navigating Patterns, which is nautical themed. So he cosplays as a sailor. And he talks about stuff like how to read Plato on your boat, why wisdom is important to navigate the rough seas, and also why we shouldn't listen to scientists. As the vast majority of scientists probably have never even traveled on a boat. So Mark uses this sailor LARPing as this sort of a manifesto for his ideology of using thinking to battle the sea of ideas. At least I think so. To be honest, I didn't really even watch one of his videos. I just saw a screenshot. So I might be wrong, but I assume it's about that. But anyway, when Mark isn't making his pirate videos about Aristotle, he likes to visit a whole range of places, and he travels around. So the crime was committed in Jacksonville, Florida, and the man was born in Vermont. Both of these places Mark has spent time in before. So the evidence was clear as day to me. There must be a direct connection. It can't just be coincidence that two people have gone to two different places in the world. I think not. So this Mark, he drives around in his golf cart frequently. I think it's because he can't afford a boat. I guess he's pretending like the golf cart is some sort of a little yacht. And the golfing greens are just like a different colored ocean. And also he stays in hostels a bunch. What would this make you think? That's right, this man is definitely a man who doesn't want to get his ID updated. So this is my working theory so far, and stay with me here. He got out of prison after 5 years, the maximum term for that charge. And in Florida, this tracks with all the laws and everything. So I logically figured that Mark must have gotten facial reconstructive surgery in order to hide that past. Basically then in 2021, Mark must have gotten a Twitter and YouTube channel. And I see that this guy has the same name as this convicted criminal. Now, I know that sounds a little crazy, but we all know that the next stage after a lengthy prison term is to start a flourishing YouTube career. I mean, look what happened to Martin Shkreli. he's making millions and millions of dollars again, after his prison term. So maybe this Mark is on the path to navigate pharmaceuticals, and he's going to raise the price of a generic, esoteric, and very specific genetic disease drug by 2,670%, and then use that money to fund the Peterson sphere. He's going to make that sphere so big that we all live inside of it. We will spend our days cleaning a collective shared room in a utopian vision of being well organized and structured. I mean, it makes sense to me, but of course, I don't know if Mark has any knowledge or history or career or experience in the drug business or major markets or the stock market or feed currency, but he probably does. I know he has a Patreon at the very least, and that's all the proof I really need. Now, if I'm blunt with you guys, I've had heaps of crazy stuff happen in my life, and honestly, this isn't the craziest thing that's ever happened. So, you know, my bad. What I deeply regret is I had never embodied Mark. I mean, yeah, because if you were that man who committed those crimes, then you really wouldn't be sneaking in all those little hints in live streams and recorded videos. You know, another reason why this might be is he always seemed to direct the conversation towards certain topics, to crimes or illegal activities. I think once he mentioned the Tor network, and he said something about a VPN, which I think is some sort of hacker term for hiding your activities from your internet service provider. I'm not sure. But if you were that person who had committed those crimes, I don't see why you'd add little hints in, especially if you didn't want to get caught again. So whether it was conscious or unconscious, I thought at the time maybe a tongue-in-cheek reference to that might have made sense, but I mean, I really wanted to rush out the piece, and in a sense, I did, because I was like, well, people are... I wouldn't be the exact person to figure this out, and anyway, I think that other people are going to figure it out soon enough. I've been going through a lot doing this, and even though my motivation might have been awful, I want to be upfront with the video and make it a proper journalistic piece. And there were some things from the video that I couldn't quite work out. For instance, here's a good example. I made the claim that Mark had the same birth date as this criminal. Now, I really wasn't sure about this. But in a sense, I was sure it was, because, you know, in the white pages, I could only find two Mark Anthony Lefebvre's in their 40s by just a year apart. Now, one lived in a four-bedroom house, and I'm like, that can't be Mark. I thought Mark lived by himself. And furthermore, I didn't actually check to see if they had the same birthday. Upon further checking, I've actually found out that no, they don't. So my bad on that one, guys. I should have actually done some rudimentary checking on that detail before claiming it, but so I could find out the details didn't actually line up. So that one is on me. Anyway, Mark always mentions that he was a key component of the underground hacking community, and I thought to myself, well, maybe if this is the second thing that he'd created, hopefully I was in search of bringing attention to the two things that would bring attention to his then potentially accused character. One is that if you show a fake ID to anyone, that would violate his probation or parole, and also that if someone is computer savvy like Mark, it could help me with that core information. So, on one random day, I flicked through the white pages, and it said that Mark lived in North Carolina, which I didn't know before, because I couldn't actually track down his Facebook page. See, I searched for Mark A. Lefebvre and Mark Anthony Lefebvre, and because I've seen him listed on other things, but he's actually just listed as Mark Lefebvre instead. So when I did find that, I found his profile and it does match to North Carolina, so I should have known to not put that there in my accusation. Now, I do realize that mentioning this again is sort of doubling down on my original sentiment, and perhaps it's effectively doxing him in essence, but what I meant to say is that essentially that Mark lives in North Carolina and not Florida or Canada, even though he has visited there, like I previously mentioned. There's some other peculiar information. If you look at his YouTube channel, he talks about a knowledge engine and a model of wisdom. He talks about these four P's of knowing. I mean, what are these four P's of knowing? Does he mean the four prisons of knowing as to his alleged time in prison? I mean, I wonder. And furthermore, he hangs around on his Discord server with one so-called Manuel Post. Now, is Manuel Post the same one who posted his bail? It really makes you stop and think. I mean, let's connect the dots further. Mark hates postmodernism. Reverse those two starting letters of Manuel Post, MP, and what did you get? PM. PM stands for, that's right, postmodernism. Yet Mark claims to not be a postmodernist, and in fact he says he hates postmodernism. Now that really makes you think. Now, if you're a fan of Mark, or his comings and goings, you'll notice that he's been a feature of live streams and videos of TLC, also known as This Little Corner. Yet, as of late, he seemed to decry the activities of TLC and distancing himself away from the name and the work. Now, I wonder why. Is it because he carries embodied trauma of This Little Corner, reminding him of that incarceration? This little corner of his jail cell? Maybe he sits there and shouts, "I don't want to engage in this little corner. This little corner reminds me too much of my time inside. I want to stay away from all corners. It's traumatic to me." Now, by all means, I don't want to re-trigger Mark's dark and traumatic past, if that's the case, but I am an investigative journalist first, and wokest feelings respect a second, so we need to get to the bottom of the truth. Anyway, all by the by, I probably will have to pay for all these mistakes. I know I'm really going to pay in the end. I'm paying physically, and it was actually very mentally stressful for me. But this is not a mistake I plan to ever make again in my life. I apologize to Mark. I've already reached out and to give apology, I think. At least I remember doing it at some point. I sincerely apologize to my fans, my audience, followers, funders, and so on. Also, sorry, Mark. I don't want to be another Washington Post or New York Times. I want to be the opposite, really. I don't want to make sure as... I want to make sure as many people see this video, because I don't want to hide my attractions. I don't want to be in New York Times and claim that Russia colluded with Trump. But, I mean, I digress. Anyway, thank you for watching again. My apologies, my bad. I dropped the ball. Especially by accusing you of being a convicted criminal. And, you know, we all have our bad days when you get out on the wrong side of the bed, and I guess that was one of mine. So, yeah, apologies, Mark. But also, like, comment, and subscribe for upcoming videos. I'm going to be releasing some shocking exposés about this Paul Vanderclay for having a Dutch name but a strong American accent. Between you and me, I don't think he's actually from Holland. I feel like it's a big psyop by big Protestantism to have us believe that Europe is more important than America. But yeah, that's all for another day. Take care, everyone.